8-month-old lab retriever astonishes the owner with his unusual discovery while digging the backyard. No matter how well off a person might be, he or she always needs a companion to share all his or her ups and downs with. And as the thought crosses the mind, one wants the other person to possess certain qualities, such as loyalty, cheerfulness, and amiableness. One who can always lift up your spirits and is always ready to be by your side. But all of these qualities might or might not be there in a particular person. But dogs, they possess these qualities by default. And similar thoughts might have crossed the mind of Kirk Lacewell when he'd thought about adopting a pup, without knowing that this pup would one day do something so normal whose consequence would make everyone gasp. When Lacewell couldn't deal with the loneliness alone, he thought of having a partner who would be there for him and make his life vivacious again. But then having a companion at this age wasn't an easy decision to make. A lot of things had to be considered beforehand.
In this world, finding a companion is even more difficult than landing up in a job. When Kirk Lacewell had an urge to have a companion, a dog seemed to be perfect. As he entered the pet shop, he'd several doubts as to which dog should he choose, but as soon as his eyes met this bubbly Labrador Retriever puppy, he felt an unknown connection and without having any second thoughts, he went ahead to adopt the pup. The Golden Labrador Retriever was everything Kirk ever wanted. He was zestful and more often made him run down the street after him. He was delighted with his company and his whole world used to revolve around the pup. And gradually he started to recover from his monotonous life. Labrador Retrievers are known for their zestful and energetic nature, but it's unbelievable that these cool-natured, family-oriented dogs were basically bred for hunting and retrieving things. Labrador Retrievers have been the most popular breed among the Americans since ages. The pup's energy was hard to match and he indulged in new mischiefs every day. Watching him grow was one of the precious moments that Kirk was cherishing. As he started to grow at a faster pace, he became fond of digging up the backyard and due to this Kirk named him Scout. But who knew this normal habit of digging will dig out things from the past that have been unknown for so long? As the duo started to share a closer bond, the adventure popped into whatever they did. Even the normal activities were more blissful and happening. The normal routine of Kirk became more tireless. Whenever Kirk was free from all the chores, he and Scout would go out to play catch and throw. Gradually, Scout started to like it and would catch the frisbee thrown at any height. When Kirk used to challenge him by throwing it to unbelievable heights, he would catch the frisbee, never disappointing him. Besides playing catch and throw, Scout loved digging the backyard. Whenever Kirk was not in sight, he used to get engrossed in the act until the owner had to come out and take him inside. Sometimes Kirk used to get annoyed with this habit of Scout's, but being the mischievous pup that he was, Scout used to get back to digging whenever Kirk got busy with his work. Due to his amiable nature, he was always the center of attraction of the neighbors. Soon after his arrival at Kirk's house, he became a darling of all the living in the vicinity. Every time Kirk used to take Scout for a walk, he used to greet everyone with his jaunty bark, attracting everyone's attention nearby. With the arrival of Scout, even Kirk used to be cheerful around people and would greet everyone in sight. Observing these changes, the people in the neighborhood too had developed a soft corner for him. Kids would come to play with Scout every now and then. No matter how much Kirk would restrain Scout from digging the backyard, he would do it anyway whenever Kirk was not in the sight. Kirk tried every possible way to make Scout stop his digging routine. He played throw and catch all day long, but all in vain, as he was not able to make him quit. After every attempt to make Scout stop, someday he used to get irritated. The other days he would laugh at this habit and wondered what treasure he's expecting to come out of the backyard. Little did he know that this normal habit of Scout's would open doors to such unanticipated consequences. Even Kirk wouldn't have imagined Scout's habit of turning stones up and down will turn someone turn stones upside down too. As Scout started growing, Lacewell used to leave him to explore on his own. He would play catch and throw with Scout in the evenings, and the rest of the day, Scout used to run around the house playing with a frisbee or entertaining the neighbors. Soon when Scout turned 8 months old, he was hard to handle because Kirk couldn't match his energy level. Despite being a bit noisy and bubbly, he was obedient and would usually roam around the house helping Kirk with household chores. It was a usual day in September when the sun was over the head yet enclosed partly in clouds. The weather had already started indicating the advent of the fall, but who knew that such a normal day would open doors to such an unforeseen past that everyone, including Kirk, will get stunned by the discovery. After finishing all the chores in the kitchen, both Kirk and Scout played catch and throw until Kirk was exhausted. So, he went on to take a nap on the couch, leaving Scout in the garden, who was still as energetic as before even after playing for so long. As usual, as Kirk made his way to his room, Scout escaped to the backyard to dig a new place, without having a clue about the unexpected discovery he was about to make. When Scout, as usual, started digging the backyard again, the pup stumbled upon a worn-out stone-like object and started barking to let Kirk know about his new discovery. Upon hearing noises from the backyard, Kirk was sure that the pup must have done some mischief again but was in no mood to go out. Even when Scout didn't stop barking, Kirk got anxious and ran out to see if the dog was safe. As he reached the backyard, the pup looked at him with gloriously expressive eyes while still holding the rusty stone-like object in his mouth as if he'd already found a treasure. But who knew that such a stinky object will actually turn out to be life-changing? As Scout saw Kirk coming out of the room, he ran towards him, wagging his tail. The pup put the stone-like object in front of Kirk's foot. Still, in a dilemma, Kirk bent down to have a closer look at the object and held up that rusty, stinky object in his hands and tried evaluating what it might be. After coming to no conclusion for the same, he left the stone to the pup and went on with his day. Several days after the incident, Kirk noticed that the pup still hasn't got over with the stone and he is carrying that stinky thing everywhere. He tried to make him leave the stone, but couldn't succeed. With every other day passing, the pup seemed just as enamored with that shabby piece of stone as the day before. Kirk became doubtful about the shabby-looking object, as he was unable to get any answers he thought about giving him a closer look. So this time, he took the stone in his hands and washed it thoroughly. It took days for the worn-out stone to dry up, but Kirk had to wait to see what the object actually was. Even after drying up, it was difficult for Kirk to make out what the object actually was. But about one thing he was sure, that the stone was no ordinary stone or just a mere piece of rock that would have left out while constructing the house. But if it wasn't, what was it? Part of it looked like a bone and had a covering over it and was partly worn off, Kirk said. Now, when Kirk was done with his research, he knew he has to reach out to an expert explanation to get answers to all the theories that were cooking up in his mind, because it was obvious the stone he was carrying was no ordinary stone. Subsequent days of mugging up about the object, he finally took some pictures of the stone and sent them to experts in the University of Washington's Burke Museum and waited for the paleontologist to reply. Now, he knew that he'll be getting an explanation to what the object really was. It was just another day of September and the leaves were falling off vigorously. But was it just another day for Kirk too? Maybe not. The mystery was going to be revealed soon, for which he was waiting for days now. So what was that shabby-looking stone that his pup had found that day? As the day came, Kirk was both anxious and excited to know what the object was. As the report came out, he was flabbergasted with the revelation of the fact that what he was thinking to be just a stinky stone, which had worn out due to the passage of time, was actually an ancient woolly mammoth tooth. Kirk found it hard to digest the fact that the place he was residing was once home to ancient mammoths who used to wander around millions of years back. This startling revelation was an unanticipated incident of his life. According to the paleontologist, the giant woolly mammoths were quite commonly found in that era. Resembling the present-time elephants, woolly mammoths were found nearly 13,000 years back. They had the same structure as that of the African elephants today, weighing nearly 4 metric tons and had a height estimated nearly between 8 to 11.2 feet. They were well-suited for the cold environment of the last ice age. These giant mammoths had long thatch of hair all over their body to protect them from the intense cold weather. They had short ears and tails to reduce the chill of the outside weather. Having characteristics similar to elephants found in today's era, they too used their tusks and trunks to sense nearby things and eatables. They mainly relied upon grasses, mainly for their survival, and had a lifespan of nearly 60 years. It is believed that the early species of humans used mammoths' tusks for varied purposes, such as for hunting, basically due to their sharp structure, and also for carving. Even certain tools were made using their tusks, and also they were hunted by early humans for food. The news of the excavation of the bone spread like wildfire, so was the popularity of Kirk and Scout too. How often does an ancient mammoth tooth get discovered? It was indeed an extraordinary circumstance in which the tooth was found in the backyard. Due to the abundant amount of woolly mammoths found in that area, the tooth was of one of the ancient mammoths that might have had their shelter where Kirk was residing now, and due to unfortunate climatic changes or timely death of the giant mammoth, it must have gotten buried under the ground with the passage of time. The one question that crossed everyone's mind was, would there be any more bones of the ancient mammoth? Typically preserved more than other parts of the mammoth, as explained by Andrea Godinez, marketing director for the Burke Museum. With the discovery of one ancient tooth, there were several questions still unanswered. Will there be more bones of the giant woolly mammoth, or this was the one of the last heritage of the giant species? But all the answers lay either under the ground or with the paleontologists. Before Kirk's pup, Scout found the bone of a mammoth. An expert in the paleontology department in museum said that in December 2010 a similar incident took place when a girl named Cecilia, who was 10 years old at that time, found a similar mammoth tooth while roaming around on the Whidbey Island with her dad. It is quite evident that Whidbey Island was once the shelter to the giant mammoths back then. After years of their existence in Whidbey Island, they were known to get extinct due to excessive climatic changes and hence resulting in their death, so their fossils still remained buried under the grounds, and upon digging they could be discovered. Research is going on to bring back the lost species by creating a hybrid to save the Arctic tundra and also to stop the greenhouse gas emission. If this research took shape, it will help to save our planet from greenhouse effects and save mankind too. The group of genetics from Howard are trying to clone the living elephant cells and some leftover DNAs of the extinct giant mammoth in order to make the theory into practice, and if this experiment becomes successful, this will help in a lot of ways to save the nature. While this seemed to an improbable idea, the experts have been working on it for the last few decades to make it feasible. Rigorous research has been going on, and experts from around the world have been working on the idea around the world. Why the beast should again be woken up when it's already asleep for good since last countless years? It is necessary because the land underlying the thick layer of ice that has been frozen for a long time. Due to the disposal of dead plants over the ice, a layer of carbon dioxide has settled on the surface. If the research results become practical, it will be possible to bring back the giant mammoths by cloning. As a result, this will bring abrupt disturbances in the layer of carbon dioxide that has been settled over for ages now. Whenever the mammoths walk on the surface, due to this desirable disturbance, the layer will release the carbon dioxide and also methane in the atmosphere. It is assumed that if these types of creatures are cloned and left on the tundra, it can help in recreating a healthy ecosystem again on the frozen Arctic. As the grass will absorb the least amount of heat and the gases will remain as a layer, due to the movement of animals over this surface, they will automatically crush the insulation that has been created. Supposedly, when the grasslands are recreated on the frozen land, it will help in liquefying the soil that has been frozen for a long time. And hence a new habitation can be created, and this will not just help bring back the extinct mammoth, but also will improve the quality of air in the atmosphere. Till now, every theory that has been given is on the papers, yet the research has been going on for decades now. If this idea materializes into reality, it will bring a positive and drastic change in the atmosphere, and all the damage that has been done until now can be undone to some extent. As of now, the discovery of the ancient tooth has astounded not only Kirk but the people in the vicinity too. The people and Kirk himself are still in awe of finding it and still trying to digest the fact that the giant beast must have lived on the same land as his house. From the day the bone has been discovered, it has felt like a part of Kirk's heirloom which he wants to save for his future generation to come. And it holds more importance for him as it was discovered by his own 8-month-old pup, so it is more precious to Kirk. This story doesn't end here. Kirk wants to find more such pieces and add to his antique collection. Though the paleontologists have clarified that they won't take the bones in possession to display it in the museum, Kirk says he won't give this precious possession to anyone, whatever they might offer in return.
After this incident, Scout, the 8-month-old Labrador Retriever, who has always been a darling pup of all the neighbors, is now their hero too. Kirk, who used to devoid him of digging, also considered himself a lucky owner. The theory of recreating the Ice Age era might take some more time to materialize, but for Kirk and other neighbors, Scout is already an achiever. The bond that Kirk and Scout share is strengthening day by day. Scout has brought remarkable changes in his life, and Lacewell considers himself the proud owner of the pup, and now he doesn't even restrain him from digging, as well with a thought that what else this little pup might discover.